birthday, Marc Mellits. He just turned 50 years old, and he is the composer of this piece called Black for two bass clarinets. It was written for a couple of good friends of mine, Jeff Anderley and Jonathan Russell, who make up the duo Squonk. Check them out on YouTube if you haven't. They are terrific, and they have some fantastic music. So go look them up, Squonk. And anyway, Marc wrote this in 2008, and it is a fantastic piece of music. And you know what? Since it just was his 50th birthday, why don't you give him a birthday present and go out and get this piece, okay? Here's the link. This is where you can find it, okay? So, yep, little plug for Marc because it's a terrific piece. So there you go. So that's the first thing. The second thing is I wanted to talk about this instrument. I'm sure you're all wondering. This is a brand new custom job that Selmer, there it is, Selmer, made for me. It's a privilege bass clarinet, but they plated it with black chrome. Now the thing that's interesting about black chrome, doesn't that look amazing? Normally bass clarinets are plated with either silver or nickel, all right? But chrome is a different metal, and the thing about chrome is that it's a little bit heavier. And the instrument itself is a little bit heavier. You can actually feel it, not substantially heavier, but the chrome itself changes the way the instrument really resonates. And I find that it is much louder than my silver-plated bass clarinet. Anyway, so Selmer, I asked Stéphane Gentil at Selmer in Paris, would you please make me an all-black bass clarinet? I have always, my whole life, I've wanted an all-black bass clarinet. And last summer, he agreed to do it. So he went ahead and had all of the pieces made, all of the keys, everything on this instrument, all of the metal is black, plated. And then he sent this instrument in pieces to a guy named Wolfgang Loof. And he is one of the, if not the premier bass clarinet, oboe, saxophone, bassoon. I don't want to call him a repairman because he actually crafts these instruments and he does some major surgery on instruments. But they sent all this stuff to him and he put it together with me. Now he uses special pads, which are conveniently also black, if you can see that. He uses an open-celled foam, which lasts a lot longer than leather. It's quieter. Can you hear that? Neither can I. The pads, they seal amazingly well. He also does this thing with the rods. Rods are these long, long, you know, keys here. Once the instrument has gone through a couple of seasons of, you know, humidity and dryness, the instrument will expand and contract and these rods will start to jiggle. If you take one of yours, you can probably move it up and down between the two posts. It'll go dicky 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 dicky. This, he's done something special to where he uses ball bearings and other voodoo that keep it from ever happening. So the instrument stays in adjustment a lot longer and, which is a good thing because I don't want to have people adjusting the keys on this thing very often because frankly I've been told that the chrome is pretty robust but I just don't want it scratched. So I'm taking super 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 good care of this and I'm really glad that it's going to stay in adjustment for a long time. So anyway, I wanted to thank Selmer and Wolfgang for making this amazing bass clarinet. I am so excited about it. It is such an amazing horn. I want to thank Marc Mellits for that beautiful piece, Black. Check that out as well. And I want to thank you for watching this video, and we will see you next time. Take care.